This time, ChargerLAB got a 140W PD3.1 dual USB-C GaN charger from Kovol. Both USB-C ports can support fast charging of 140W when used respectively. It comes with foldable USB prongs and an indicator light. Next, let's take it apart and look at its internal components. The Kovol 140W and 4000 points are printed on the box. And the back has other 1000 points and specs info, which we'll talk about later. Open the box. The white surface has a matte design. The Kovol is printed on the front. The specs info are also printed on the bottom. Model is P66-2C-140W-UK. It can support input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 2.0 amp. The total charging power is 134.4 watts. It has passed CE UK CE certifications. The foldable USB prongs are for easy storage. The output panel has an indicator and two green USB-C ports. The size of it is about 88 by 69 by 33 mm. It is smaller than the Apple 140W charger. The weight is about 305 grams. ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows that the USB-C1 supports FCP, ICP, EFC, QC3.0, QC5, PE2.0, PD3.1, PPS, DCP, and Apple 2.4 amp protocols. And it has 6 fixed PDOs of 5 volts, 9 volts, 12 volts, 3 amp, 50 volts, 20 volts, 28 volts, 5 amp, and a set of PPS. The supported protocols of USB-C2 are the same as the USB-C1. So are the PDOs. Now, we are going to use some tools to take it apart. Take out the PCB module. Both sides of the PCB module have thermal pies and are fixed with glue. The foldable prongs are soldered to the PCB module through wires. It also has copper sheets to enhance heat dissipation. Cut the wires and remove the heat sinks. All the gaps between the components are filled with potting compound for fixing and heat dissipation. Clean up the PCB module. There are fuse, common mode choke, safety X2 capacitor, and a bridge rectifier on the front. The master control chip, optocoupler, MOSFET, and synchronous rectifier controller are on the back. ChargerLab found it adopts a PFC circuit and LLC topology with fixed output voltage. Next, we'll take a look at each component starting from the input end. The input fuse is from Chevron, 5 amp, 250 volts. The resistor is used to suppress the surge current when powering on. The common mode choke is wound with magnet and insulated wires. The safety X2 capacitor is from WQC, 0.47 microfarad. The second common mode choke is wound with flat copper wires. The bridge rectifier is from Pingwei, 15 amp, 1000 volts. The specs of these two film filter capacitors are 0.47 microfarad, 450 volts. The filter inductor is wound with magnetic ring and insulated by heat shrinkable tubing. The NTC thermistor is used to suppress the surge current when powering on. Then, let's take a look at the primary side. The master control chip is from NXP. It is a digitally configurable combo controller for LLC and PFC. The electrolytic capacitor that powers the master control chip is from HWE, 22 microfarad, 50 volts. These two GaN FETs are from Navitas and adopt QFN 6x8mm package. They integrate drivers and support a switching frequency of 2 MHz, 175 mA, 650 volts. Two sampling resistors are used to detect the current of the MOSFET, 90 mA for each. The magnetic core of the PFC boost inductor is insulated by tape. The PFC silicon carbide rectifier is from Maplesemi and adopts DFN 5x6 package. It can support a continuous positive current at 150 degrees Celsius, 650 volts, 6 amp. The electrolytic capacitor is from HWE, 100 microfarad, 450 volts. These two LLC MOSFETs are from WAYON and adopts DFN 8x8 package, 650 volts, 160 mΩ. The magnetic core of the resonant inductor is insulated by tape. The resonant capacitor is from WDC, 0.033 microfarad, 630 volts. The LLC transformer is wound with ATQ2516 magnetic core and insulated by tape. Then we come to the secondary side. The SMD Y capacitor is from TRX. Its small size and lightweight are suitable for high density power products such as GaN fast chargers. The other SMD Y capacitor is the same as the previous one. The optocoupler is from Everlight and is used for output voltage feedback. The synchronous rectifier controller is from MXP. It has two built-in drivers for the LLC circuit. These two synchronous rectifiers are from Hunteck and adopt DFN 5x6 package, 100 volts, 4.6 mΩ. Finally, let's introduce the upper end. The solid capacitor for output featuring is from Polycap RT series, 680 microfarad, 35 volts. The output filter inductor is wound with magnet ring and insulated with big light. There are inductors, MOSFETs, protocol chips, controllers, and capacitors on the front of the bulk PCBs. The VBUS MOSFET, sampling resistor, and USB-C socket are on the back. The protocol chip is from Ingenic. It integrates programmable voltage current loop control and current detection. It also supports loose composition of output. The synchronous buck controller is from source chip. It can be configured as dual output or single output. The output voltage can be set by resistors for constant power control. The synchronous buck MOSFET is from Rechips and adopts PDFN3333 package, 40 volts, 5.5 mΩ. This synchronous buck MOSFET is the same as the previous one. The SMD solid capacitor for output featuring is from Polycap VA series, 100 microfarad, 35 volts. The VBUS MOSFET is from WAYON and adopts PDFN3030-8L package, 40 volts, 10 mΩ. There is the green USB-C socket. Here is the LED indicator. Well, those are all components of the Kovol 140W PD3.1 dual USB-C GaN charger. It has a white matte surface and a foldable prongs make it easy to carry. After taking it apart, we found it adopts a PFC circuit and LLC topology. It also has two independent buck circuits. It adopts a lot of thermal pies and copper sheets for heat dissipation. And the PCBA module is filled with putty compound. All of this can make it meet the requirements of high power charging and keep the charger not too hot. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!